Hi friends, good afternoon to all. Myself, I am B. Commerce Faro, studying 2nd BPC. I am from TSWREIS JC Girls, both at Adilabad District. Now, my friends are introducing themselves.
Hi friends, this is Sakshi Swaro from 2nd BPC.
Hi friends, this is Priyanka Swaro from 2nd BPC.
Hi Swaros, this is Mansi Swaro from 2nd BPC.
Hi Swaros, this is Purnami Swaro from 2nd BPC.
Okay friends, Sakshi's hair is looking so beautiful and it was so silky, no? So, Sakshi, can you tell how you get that silky hair?
Yes, I get silky hair from my mother.
Okay, Sakshi gets silky hair from her mother. Yeah. And Purnami's skin color is so fair, na? Purnami, can you tell how you get that silk fair hair?
I get from my mother.
Okay, Purnami also get that fair color from her mother.
Yes.
Okay, friends, are you get any other characters from your parents?
Yes, I get.
Yeah, Priya, please tell me.
My hat is equal to my father's hat.
Okay.
Can I Komal?
Yeah, please Mansi.
My face is similar to my mother's face.
Okay, your face is similar to your mother's face. So guys, you are the second year students, but looking like just small kids, right? So I'll show you some of the toys.
Wow.
Are you like it?
Yes.
Okay friends, so in these toys, some of the offspring toys are there and some of the parents toys are there. What you have to do means, you have to match these offspring toys with their parents toys. Okay, so tell me who will come first?
Myself.
Yeah, please, Sakshi. Then,
can I come, Komal?
Yeah, Priya.
Can I come on?
Yeah, please, Mansi.
Shall I come on?
Of course. Yeah, guys, show me now what you have matched. Yes, guys, you are absolutely right that. So, you have matched the offsprings with their parents, right? And you are exactly correct. So, appreciate you all. So, now tell me how you are able to match that offsprings with their parents. I mean, how do you thought that they might be their parents and they might be their offsprings? Tell me.
By be watching same color.
Okay, by watching same color. And?
And by watching their shape.
By watching the shape. Again?
Because the characters are similar.
Okay.
By observing their feet are similar.
Right. So, by observing their characters, their shape, their size, you are able to find out that they might be their offsprings and they might be their parents, right?
Yes.
So, tell me guys, what do you have observed in this activity?
Offsprings are similar to their parents.
Yes, Purnami, you are absolutely right that offsprings are similar to their parents. Okay, offsprings are similar to their parents. Then tell me, how the offsprings are similar to their parents? Do you know that? Okay, so let's discuss today in this session. How offsprings are similar to their parents, right? How offsprings are similar to their parents. Then tell me guys, what do you think about it? Guys, are you want to discuss among yourselves?
Yes!
Okay then, discuss among yourselves and tell to me later.
What is the reason behind it?
I think genetic.
Maybe
heredity?
Yes, exactly you are right that. It is because of heredity. The offsprings are similar to their parents because of heredity, right? Then what is this heredity?
The transmission of genetic characters from parents to progeny.
Yes, Purnami, you are absolutely right. The transmission of genetic characters from parents to progeny. What is meant by progeny?
It's children.
Yes, it's children. So, the transmission of genetic characters from parents to progeny is nothing but heredity. Then what is genetics here?
Myself.
Yeah, please, Sakshi.
The scientific study of how traits are inherited from parents to children is known as genetic.
Yes, yes, you are exactly right then. The scientific study of how traits are inherited from parents to progeny is nothing but genetics. Right? Yeah. Did you get my point?
Yes.
Okay. Komal, I have one doubt. What is the meaning of inherit?
Okay, inherit means nothing but receiving traits from parents. Right? Receiving traits from parents is nothing but inherit.
Then what is the meaning of traits?
Traits are characters or features. Okay.
Okay,
characters are nothing but traits. So, the transmission of characters from parents to progeny is nothing but genetics. Now, can you give some examples me again?
F- For example, hair color.
Yes, hair color.
Shape of the nose.
Shape of the nose.
And also structure.
Yes, structure also.
And skin color.
Yes, very good. So, these all are the examples of genetics. Okay guys, listen here. The chromosomes in the nucleus of the cell has contained all the information regarding inherit of traits from parents to progeny in the form of DNA molecules. Guys, did you get my point? Okay, don't worry. I'll explain again. Right. So, do you know what are the DNA molecules?
Yes.
Tell me anyone.
Can I, Komal?
Yeah, please, Punnami.
DNA is a nucleic acid that contains genetic instructions specifying the biological development of all cellular forms of life.
Yes, it's nothing but DNA molecules. Okay. So, see here. This is the structure of DNA molecule. Okay. Are you side friends? Okay. This is nothing but DNA molecule. So, DNA molecule has double helix structure. Right? Yeah. DNA has double helix structure and this is the structure of it. So, what I want to tell is, listen carefully. So, these DNA molecules is present in?
In the nucleus, chromosome.
Yes, you are absolutely right. DNA molecules are present in chromosomes. Then tell me guys, where the chromosomes are present?
In the nucleus.
Right. Where the nucleus is present?
In the cell.
Exactly. I want to tell that part. So, the chromosomes in the nucleus of the cell has contained all the information regarding how traits are inherited from parents to progeny. Okay, so that all information will be present in the form of these DNA molecules. Right? Did you get my point now?
Yes.
Okay then. Are you understood friends about this?
Yes.
Komal.
Yeah, Purnami?
I have one doubt.
Ask me please.
Are we get all traits from our parents?
Okay, Purnami's doubt is, are we get all traits from our parents, right?
Yes.
So, Punami, before clarifying your doubt, here we have to remember one of the great personality is none other than Grigor John Mendel. Do you know about Grigor John Mendel?
Yes.
Can anyone tell about him?
Yes, I will tell.
Yeah, please, Priya.
John Mendel was considered as father of genetics, and why? Because he was considered the genetics, so that's why we call him as father of genetics.
Okay, so here Mendel was regarded as a father of genetics, or Mendel is the founder of genetics. Right. So, according to Mendel's first law, right? According to Mendel's first law, each parent has two copies of genes. Okay. Each parent has two copies or two sets of genes. But they will give only one copy of trait to their children. Right. Each parent has two copies of traits, but they will give only one copy of genes to their child. Okay. This is the Mendel's first law. So, has a offsprings means has a children, we have some combinations of our parents. Right. This is because our parents will give some of themselves to us. Means they will give some of the genes to us. That is the reason we all are resemble our parents. Right? So friends, a child is made up of how the information will be found in cells of parent. Right? So these characteristics are nothing but genes.
Genes.
Okay? Are you get my point?
Yes.
So these are nothing but genes. Guys, do you know how human beings life will be start?
Yes.
Yes. By egg produced by our mother and fertilized by our father, and it finally comes at embryo, right? So like that our life will be start. So friends, when we start our life, right? When we start our life, we all are came with some of the pre-packaged set of direction. Okay? So these direction made us how to grow up, how to be look like, and how to be an individual, right? So here what is the direction represent?
Genes.
Yes, it's nothing but genes. You are right. So genes made us how to be grow, how to be look like, and how to be an individual, right? So friends, do you know where the genes are present?
In the chromosomes.
Yes, you are absolutely right that genes are present in chromosomes. So these genes are present in chromosome. The chromosome are tiny body cells. Tiny means?
It's too small.
Right, it's too small. So genes are present in 46 tiny body cells, nothing but chromosome. So these chromosomes carry all the information from our parents to progeny. Right? Did you get my point?
Yes.
Okay friends, then tell me, do you know about phenotype and genotype?
Yes.
Do you know about phenotype and genotype? Right? Okay, then tell me Punami, what is phenotype?
It's our outer appearance.
Right. Phenotype is our outer appearance, means what we can observe in one person. Right? When we saw them, like their shape of eye or shape of head. So sometimes our neighbors are said that, no, are she was look like same her father. Are she has same eyes like her mother, like that. Some of the characters we get from our grandparents also. So that is nothing but phenotype. Means what we can observe when we saw one person. That is phenotype. Okay, then what is genotype? Okay, sometimes our neighbors also said that, hey, her angerness is similar to her grandparents, right? Her politeness is similar to her parents. Her helping nature is similar to her parents. So, these all are nothing but genotype, means the characteristics which we can't see, right? So, what is in the genes? What will be present in the genes is nothing but genotype. Okay, are you understood now? What is phenotype and what is genotype?
Yes.
Okay, friends. So, let's imagine that one of the war occurs between both of you. So, both of you are belonging to one party and both of you are belonging to one party. Okay. And between both of your parties, one war will be occurs. And here, you have one special type of power. Right. You have one special type of power. Then tell me that who will win the match?
We will win the match.
Why?
Why? Because we have a special type of power and we dominate them.
Right. You have a special type of power. So, you will win the match. And here, you dominate them. So, tell me who are the dominants here?
Yes, we are the dominants.
Right. Then, who are the recessive here?
We are the recessive.
Right. So, you are the dominants and you are the recessive, right? So, has similar in our genes also, right? Has similar in our genes also. One gene is powerful than other gene, right? So, the powerful gene will be act as dominant and another gene will be there, no? That is act as recessive, right? This is dominant and recessive. So, friends, do you know about chromosomes?
Yes.
Can anyone explain about chromosomes?
Can I come on?
Yeah, please, Mansi.
Chromosome is a thread-like structure. In the human body, there are 23 pairs of chromosomes. In the 23, 22 are autosomes and one is dissimilar. It is known as allosomes or sex chromosomes.
Right, Mansi, you are absolutely right. That as a human means we have 23 types of chromosomes. In the 23 types of chromosomes, 22 types of chromosomes are similar. So, they are called as autosomes. And that one pair is dissimilar, no? So, one pair, that pair is called as allosomes or sex chromosomes. Okay. So, when a mother and father will conceive a child, okay? When a mother and father will conceive a child, so, the 23 chromosomes will come from mother and 23 chromosomes come from father. So, like that, a baby has total 23 pairs of chromosomes, right? So, did you get my point now?
Yes.
Okay then. So, friends, here what do you understand that? Half of the chromosomes will come from mother and half of the chromosome come from father. Right? Are you have any doubts?
Komal, I have one doubt.
Yeah,
can you please give another example for recessive and dominant?
Okay, you want another example for recessive and dominant.
Komal.
Yeah, Sakshi.
I have also one doubt.
Yeah, please.
My brother has get many characters from my mother and my grandparents, but he didn't get any characters from my father. Why? What is the reason?
Okay, your doubt is your brother has get many characters from your mother and grandparents, but he didn't get any characters from your father, right? And you want another example for dominant and recessive. Okay then, I'll clear both of your doubts. Okay, so for clearing your doubts, I'll use one chart here, right? So friends, look at this chart, right? So, do you know what are the allosomes of a female?
X.
Yes, it's X and S. And what are the allosomes of a male?
X and Y.
Right, it's X and Y. So, consider here a female has X and X allosomes, right? Okay, so X and X allosomes. So, consider that this female has black color eye. Okay, this female eye color is
black. Color eye.
So, here capital B means black and that male has brown color eye. Right. So, small b consider
brown color.
So, when the cross-section will be happen, when the cross-section will be happen in both of this male and female, right? This female and male, when the cross-section will be happen, they will give birth to some child like this. If the capital B, the X capital B of female and X small b of male will consider a child here. Look at this. Are you get my point?
Yes.
Okay. So, the capital B of female and small b of male will conceive a baby, then it has a capital B and a small b, means the child will get
black color eye,
right? So, when the X capital B and Y, okay, X capital B chromosome of female and Y chromosome of male will conceive a child, then the child has X capital B and Y, means
black color eye.
Here capital B is the dominant one and small b is the recessive one. So, capital B will be appears out, right? So,
Here also the child has black color eye. Then again, if X capital B chromosome of female and X small b chromosome of male will conceive a child, then they have black. X capital B and X small b means black color eye. And again, the X capital B of female and Y of male will conceive a child, then the baby has X capital B and Y means
black color eye.
So, these are the F1 generation, right? This is the F1 generation. Again, so when the F1 generation child will come, right? So, when the cross section will be happen in these two, this X capital B and X small b and X capital B and Y. So, this is a female and this is a male, right? So, when the cross section will be happen in both of them, right? When the cross section will be happen in both of them, then they will give birth to some child. Look at here. Okay, are you see it, friends?
Yes.
Right, so, X capital B of male and X capital B of female will conceive a child. It has X capital B and X capital B means
black color eye.
Again, the X capital B of female and Y of male will conceive a child which has X capital B and Y. Right? It's also
black color eye.
And again, the X small b and X capital B we conceive a child. Are there any capital B is there?
Yes.
It means dominant is there. So, which eye color is get this child?
Black color.
Black color only. Right. So, again the X small b and Y will conceive a male child. So, now tell me which eye color is get by this child?
Brown color eye.
Exactly. So, do you observe here, friends? In first generation, no brown color eye is there. Okay. In F1 generation, no brown color eye is there. But in F2 generation, the brown color eye will be there. So, has similar. Sakshi, first, Mansi, did you understood what is dominance and recessive?
Yes, Kamal.
Yes, okay. Then, Sakshi, your doubt is there, no? So, consider this female and male has your grandparents, right? And consider this F1 generation has your father's generation. And this F2 generation has your generation. So, what happened means, here your grandfather has brown color eye. But in your father's generation, there is no brown color eye. But come to your generation, your brother get again brown color eye. So, this is because actually your father has also this gene. Okay, brown color eye gene is present in your father's generation, but it will be in recessive form. So, that is the reason your father didn't get that eye. But again come to your generation, your brother has brown color eye. Means he get the brown color eye from your grandparent. Right? Did you get my point?
Yes.
So, this is because sometimes we will get the genes of our grandparents, but we didn't get the genes from our parents.
Koman, actually, I have one doubt.
Yeah, please, Priya.
Sometimes our parents give birth to a female child and sometimes our parents are giving birth to a male child. So, what is the reason for this and how it is possible?
Yes, Priya, your question is absolutely right and it was so nice also. So, right, we also know that sometimes parents will give birth to female child and sometimes they give birth to male child. So, what is the reason means? Do you know about allosomes, right?
Yes.
What are the allosomes of female?
X and Y.
Right. And what are the allosomes of male?
X and Y.
Okay. So, I'll show one chart to you about this, right? So, here, consider this is a female has allosomes of X and X means sex chromosomes, right?
Yes.
And a male has allosomes X and Y. So, your doubt is sometimes they will give birth to male child and sometimes they will give birth to female child, right? So, when the cross section will be happens in both of them. So, the female produced X, right? So, the X produced by female and sperms produced by male. Okay. So, when the cross section will be happen in them, the fertilization will be occurs, right? By the fertilization only, no? We are here now.
Yes.
Right. So, fertilization will be occur. So, look at this. When the X chromosome of female, right? When the X chromosome of female and X chromosome of male will conceive a child, the child has two chromosomes which are
X and X.
Means they will give birth to
female child.
Again, the X chromosome of female and Y chromosome of male will conceive a child, will give birth to a child. That child has X and Y chromosome means
male child.
Right. Again, the X chromosome of female and X chromosome of male will conceive a child. That child had X and X means female child. The X chromosome of female and Y chromosome of male will give birth to a male child which has X and Y chromosomes. Right, friends? So, this is the reason. Means, which chromosomes are present in sex determination? Which chromosomes are participate in sex determination? It is the reason that they will give sometimes birth to female child
and sometimes give birth to male child. Okay. So there was always 50-50 chances of give birth to female or give birth to male. Okay.
Komal,
this is the reason. Yeah, Mansi?
I have one doubt.
Okay, please.
What is the function of autosomes?
Right. This is the excellent doubt. Are you get this doubt, friends?
Yes.
Because the sex chromosome has one use. Right. The sex chromosome has their work. Then what is the work of remaining 22 pairs of autosomes? Let me tell you. So that 22 pairs of chromosomes will participate in other genes. Means like our hair color, our shape of eye, and how we have to appear, how your human being will be formed. Okay. So remaining all the functions, remaining all the genes will be present in that 22 pairs of chromosomes. Right. So that autosomes has the use of remaining making all the features. Right. Only these allosomes are participate in sex chromosome, and remaining 22 pairs of autosomes will participate in other activities, right? In other features. Did you get that point?
Yes, Kamal.
Okay, friends. Did you have any other queries?
Yes.
Yeah, please, Kunami.
Sometimes twins are similar, but sometimes they are dissimilar. Why? What is the reason for it?
Okay, Punami, your doubt is sometimes twins are similar and sometimes twins are different. So let me tell you what is twin first, right? Twins are the two offsprings. Offsprings means nothing but
children.
Okay. Twins are the two offsprings which will be formed in only one pregnancy, right? Means sometimes the female will give birth to two offsprings within one pregnancy. So what happens? Sometimes they are similar and sometimes they are dissimilar, no? So what happened here means the twins are sometimes monozygotic and sometimes dizygotic. If the twins are monozygotic, mono means?
One.
Okay. So monozygotic means one zygote. If the twins are be present in only one zygote, okay, what happened here means in only one zygote there will be two embryos will be formed, right? In only one zygote two embryos will be formed, and later they will be divided, right? When they are divided, so they has similar characters because they will be developed in only one zygote, no? So that is the reason sometimes the twins are similar. And again one is why the twins are dissimilar.
Yes.
So what happens sometimes is that dizygote also present in pregnancy. Di means
two.
Okay. So sometimes what happens means there are two zygote will be present. Right. Two zygote will be present and each one zygote will develops into an embryo and they will give birth to child. So on that time the twins are dissimilar. Right.
Yes.
So that is the reason monozygotic and dizygotic. That is the reason that twins are sometimes similar. As like we said that no, did by did. Like that. And sometimes they are dissimilar. Okay. Did you get my point?
Yes.
Okay, friends. Did you have any other queries?
No.
Okay. Right. Are you want to explain anything?
Yes. I will tell. In this session, we learn how the chromosomes are divided. And also, we learn how life begins. And also, we learn that phenotype and genotype. Can you tell phenotype?
Yes, Priya. It's nothing but our outer appearance.
And genotype?
It is inner makeup, means what is in the gene.
So like this, we learnt many things in this session, and also we learnt dominance characters and etc. And it finally we learnt that how offsprings are similar to their parents.
Okay, friends. So we learnt this all about, no? So let's see in one's PPT, because we all are like that PowerPoint presentation, no? So let's see once in PPT. So first, what we discuss about? Discuss about DNA structure, no?
Yes.
So what we discuss, the DNA is present in chromosome, chromosome is present in nucleus, and nucleus is present in
cell.
So let's see, do you want to watch that moment?
Do you want to
watch that picture?
Yes.
So let's see. Okay. Okay, so we also know that genetics about, right? I'll also explain that inheritance and trace. Can anyone tell what is inherit?
Transferring of genes.
Right, transferring of genes. And what is meant by trace? It's nothing but characters, no? Right.
Yes.
So we'll explain about that also. And then we'll explain about, tell me anyone?
Phenotype and genotype.
Okay, again?
How life begins.
Alright, then?
And dominant and recessive.
Okay, can anyone explain about how life begins? That I'll said no, the egg produced by a female and the sperms produced by male will conceive a child, right? About that. So friends, we said about DNA molecule. So let's see that picture. Okay, let's see this picture. So in this picture, what will be present there? cell. Right. In that picture, cell will be present there. And what will be present in the cell?
Nucleus.
Yes, nucleus will be there. Did you observe that carefully?
Yes.
Okay. Then what will be present in that nucleus?
Chromosomes.
Yes, chromosomes. Do you observe the structure of chromosome?
Yes.
Point out the points, how they are. Draw their structures in our notebook because it was very, very important for examination purpose.
Yes, chromosome.
Right? Okay, tell me now, what is present in that chromosome?
DNA molecule.
Okay, right. So, after the DNA molecule, we also learn about Mendel, no?
Yes.
Can anyone repeat again about Mendel?
Yes, I will repeat.
Yeah, please, Priya.
Mendel was considered as father of genetics, okay, and he was lived in 18th mid century.
Yes, right. So, and then what will we have learned? About the child, no? How yes. our life begins. So, once you want to see that picture?
Yes.
Okay, right. So, the egg produced by a mother and sperms produced by a female, right, will be fused together. So, let's see once that picture. Okay. In this picture, observe carefully, friends. In this picture, there was a female is there and one of the male is there. So, the egg produced by this female will have 23 pairs of chromosomes, right?
Yes.
So, the egg produced by the female and the sperms produced by the male will fuse it together. What happened there?
Zygote.
Right. So, zygote will be formed means fertilization will be occurred there. They, both of them, the egg and sperms are fused together to form a baby. So, zygote will be formed there. So, in the zygote, how many pairs of chromosomes are there?
46.
23
pairs. 23, Priya. It's 23 pairs of chromosomes are there. Means 46 individual chromosomes are there. So, later that zygote will be developed into an embryo. Right? So, means it will be give birth to a child. So, how many chromosomes that child receive from their mother?
46.
No.
From mother.
23 pairs of chromosomes.
Yes, 23 chromosomes from mother and 23 chromosomes from father. Right. So, again what we have explained?
About chromosomes.
Right. Can you tell about chromosome?
Can I come?
Yeah, please.
In the chromosome, in the human body, there are 23 pairs of chromosomes. In the 23, 22 are autosomes and one is allosome or sex chromosome.
Can anyone tell what is the work of allosomes? Okay, right. So, already we have discussed about them, chromosomes, no? So, can you, so I also show one of the set of female, right? One of the set of chromosomes to you. And we have only one set of chromosomes here, means 23 pairs of chromosomes here. And it's regarding to male, right? So, I'll show one of the set of chromosomes to you that is regarding male. So, see that picture, friends. In that picture, 23 pairs of chromosomes are there, right? 23 pairs of chromosomes are there, and in the 23 pairs of chromosomes, do you observe that 22 pairs are similar to each other?
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
22 pairs are similar to each. There was numbering there, no? 1, yes. 2 to 22. Right. And remaining one pair is dissimilar. That is nothing but X and Y. So, it belongs to male. Right. So, these 23 pairs of chromosomes are belonging to male. So, in females also, has similar that chromosomes are present, but in the place of Y, there is a X chromosome, right? In the place of Y, there is a X chromosome. So, in male, there has X and X allosomes. And in female, there has
X and Y,
right? So, are you understood all this topic?
Yes.
Are you have any other doubts?
No.
So, right, very good. So, can anyone give quick recap to this topic?
Yes, I will give.
Yeah, please, Priya.
In this session, we learned many things like chromosomes. Can you tell about chromosomes?
Yes. In the human body, there are 23 pairs of chromosomes. In the 23, 22 are autosomes and one is dissimilar. It is known as allosomes or sex chromosomes.
And also we learned how life was begins. And also we learned autotrophs and allotrophs. And also we learned phenotype and xenotype.
Yes, Priya. Phenotype is nothing but our outer appearance.
And xenotype?
Yes, Priya.
Okay, no problem.
Genotype is
our inner makeup.
Right.
So, like this, we learnt many things in this session.
Okay, friends, thanks for supporting me. And I would like to thank our Supreme Secretary, sir, our Principal, ma'am, Srimati B.M. Suvarnalata, ma'am, and Subject Teacher, Zoology, ma'am, Jyoti, ma'am, and my friends, and especially the TSAT channel, who are supporting a lot and give this opportunity to me. Thank you.